What's happening, guys? Keith here with another edition of the Impact Report. So this past Saturday, yesterday, Josh Matthews and Sanjay went live on either Twitter or Facebook, and they have added another match to the Redemption pay-per-view. So that will be a six-way dance between Brian Cage, Taiji Ishimori, Trevor Lee, DJ Z, Desmond Xavier, and Phantasma. Pretty big match. No stipulations as of yet, if there is going to be any, but it should be a great match, and I'm looking forward to that. They also said that there will be another match announced tomorrow morning, and they seemed really hyped for that one, but no idea what that's going to be. I'm going to speculate a little. Maybe it's going to be a Knockouts Ultimate X match for the number one contendership, or a ladder match featuring the Knockouts. Maybe a cage match between Taya and Rosemary. I don't know. I don't know if it's even just going to be with the Knockouts. I just figure since they only had one match on the card that maybe they would, you know, showcase them in another way. Let me know what you guys think might be that match. I'm curious to know what your thoughts are on it, but they seemed hyped, so it should be great news. So we learned that on Sunday, June 3rd, we will have another Impact One Night Only taping. This one partnered with Destiny World Wrestling called Zero Fear, and it has Pentagon Jr. pictured, so that's pretty big news. And it was also confirmed that Pentagon Jr. will be there for the Impact tapings taking place in Windsor, Ontario, on June 1st and 2nd. We also learned that there will be a Twitch special with Impact Wrestling and Rise called Rise of the Knockouts, and that will be taped on July 7th in Naperville, Illinois. No idea when both of those specials will go up, but that's great. Looking forward to both of those. Should be interesting. And this week, Ed Nordholm was featured on the Killing the Town podcast, where Cyrus, a.k.a. Don Callis, sat down with Ed, and they discussed a whole bunch of Impact Wrestling-related things. I'm just going to go over some of the key things they talked about. But they talked about the IP agreement and wanting it to evolve and become more of a collaboration. But their main focus right now is fixing the TV show, which is fantastic because of the fact that, you know, that's their biggest outlet, getting almost, you know, 400,000 viewers a week. And, you know, that's really where your main focus should be. Their plan is to get Shop Impact to be a hub for wrestlers to sell their merchandise in a more efficient way. You know, they talked about wrestlers going to shows and having to lug merchandise around with them and sit, you know, in intermissions before and after the show and have to, you know, kind of rely on that in order to gain some extra money. So Impact kind of wants it to be more of a streamlined process with an efficient way of getting merchandise to the fans. Because Don had mentioned that, you know, that wasn't the norm years ago, but now it seems to be a more common thing. They talk about surprises for the Redemption pay-per-view and the TV tapings. They have a 12-month vision. They want to be on the road more and less dependent on tapings in such large quantities. They say that the next taping after Redemption will be 4 weeks shorter than the previous set of tapings, and the ones in Windsor will be even shorter, so they're on the right path there, because I think that's the best way to do it, especially, you know, with it being a promotion where you see new faces all the time. I think this is the best way to do it, and hopefully, you know, that we get more of a consistent pattern here, which I think that's really what they're going for, is they want Impact to be more consistent and, you know, they want to gain the trust of the viewers. So by doing that, consistency is the way to go. They don't think, however, that they will go back to, you know, a weekly live show, because that's just how the economy is now and that it basically would be impossible. But they do realize that the blocks need to be shorter, which I just talked about, with the Orlando tapings being shorter and then the Windsor tapings being even shorter than that. And they will be returning to the UK, which I talked about maybe weeks ago, in September, and their plan is to go back to India as well, as they have some of their, that is one of their biggest markets. I think they said their YouTube viewers were, they had a lot in India, and, you know, their viewership was there as well. And speaking of viewership, this past week's Impact drew 381,000 viewers and ranked number 100 on Cable's top 150. Like I said last week, that they were going to have a down week during the WrestleCon weekend, which we saw a huge drop off, but we're back in the mix right here. This is their third highest viewership on Pop TV. So, you know, things in the right direction. And I think with adding talent such as Pentagon and Phoenix, and, you know, them talking about surprises for the pay-per-view and the next set of tapings, you may have bigger names that these numbers will just keep climbing. And, you know, that's all we can hope for. So good news as usual. We had the teleconference this week with Austin Aries. He was asked about challenging for the Lucha Underground Championship. He said that has not crossed his mind, but you never say never in the world of professional wrestling. He says the departure of Alberto El Patron was unfortunate, but they are moving on, and he thinks that, you know, at WrestleCon that match was better than the tag match would have been. So, you know, flipping a negative into a positive. He says the wrestling landscape is unlike anything he's seen. The WrestleCon weekend was a great thing for wrestling, a huge success. I mean, you know, he did praise WWE for bringing all the fans there, so it's a positive for everybody. And then he sees himself as the proof that Impact Wrestling has changed. He says that management isn't stressing people out. They're giving them creative freedom and making for a positive locker room. He thinks Impact Wrestling can be different, great, and a place for quality talent to make money. So that's always a good thing. He says he's doing cool things with Ring of Honor because it makes fans scratch their heads for a bit. It helps to build a bridge between companies. He talks about being the belt collector and how he's able to do cool things with all different companies. I believe he had added another belt to his collection this past weekend. I think it was the Defy World Championship, beating Shane Strickland on either Friday or Saturday. He talks about up-and-coming talent. He speaks about Brian Cage, Ishimori, Desmond Xavier, Sami Callihan, and Eli Drake, to which he says that he thinks the best is still ahead of him, Eli Drake, that is. And he said that's just to name a few. He talks about Impact being a place where people can make their names. Then he talked about TNA being referenced on WWE TV this past week, and he said that they should update the way they refer to the company. He says Impact is always hiring, and there is a lot of great reasons to come work for Impact Wrestling. He also goes on to mention that they won't fine you for smoking a bit of marijuana. My personal thought on the whole thing, you know, I didn't take it as a shot to the company, but the funny thing is that WWE is bringing in all this talent, call-ups, whatever you want to call it, and while this time of year is a time for them to be signing people and, like I said, calling it up, it's also a time of year where they're going to be letting go of talent. There's a bunch of wrestlers in WWE that I think could use a change of scenery, maybe update their character, you know, just because they've been stuck in the WWE system for so long that they've kind of become stale and irrelevant. So, you know, I think that it's definitely a good thing that Impact is always hiring. And then last but not least, Jeff Cobb had tweeted yesterday afternoon, "I know it's last minute. Anyone running on April 22nd? LOL." So I don't know if that's a hint that he's going to be at Redemption, maybe trolling the fans, but it's interesting to say the least. So that's pretty much it. That's all I really have for you guys. This week coming up, we're going to have a bunch of stuff. We got, obviously, the Impact review on Thursday. Hopefully Friday, have a preview and predictions video for the Redemption pay-per-view. Then I'll have some sort of Impact report. It may be added in with the preview and prediction video. And then we have the review following the Redemption pay-per-view on Sunday, April 22nd. So, another good week for Impact, and like I said, things are on the rise. It's fun to be along for the ride. So thanks for checking out my video. Well, actually, this is just audio, but thanks for checking it out. And until next time, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.